Welcome to How to Make Your Wife Happy and Healthy. Today's episode, I'm going to share with you some tips and tricks I learned from the Food Network. In fact, there's some great recipes on there, especially from one of my favorite chefs. Want to know who he is? Come on, let's get cooking. It's winter in California, and that means barbecue season. It's time to oil and heat up the grill and put on your favorite hamburgers. We're going to add a very great cheese that I was inspired by from Bobby Flay himself to make this burger taste extra special. Here are the ingredients to make the cheeseburgers. 6 ounces of shredded cheese. Most packages are 8 ounces, so you're going to use most of an 8-ounce pack. Cheddar cheese is appropriate. I'm using a Mexican-style blend. 1/4 cup of mayonnaise. 1/4 cup of roasted bell peppers, chopped. 1/4 teaspoon of cayenne pepper. 1/4 teaspoon of black pepper. 1/4 teaspoon of salt. About 1.5 pounds of ground beef. Sure, you can freeze it, but the hamburgers will taste much better if the beef is fresh. 4 hamburger buns. Here are some optional ingredients. Avocados. Lettuce. Sliced tomatoes. Bacon. Barbecue sauce. First you want to do is add 1/4 cup of mayonnaise into a mixing bowl. I'm going to add the spices to it and mix it up thoroughly. That way the flavor gets all mixed into the mayonnaise, which will get mixed in with the cheese. So we put in our 1/4 cup of mayonnaise. Add 1/4 teaspoon of salt. Add 1/4 teaspoon of black pepper. And add 1/4 teaspoon of the red cayenne pepper. Adds a little bit of kick. But that's not the ingredient that makes it extra special. Okay, once you got all the ingredients in there, you're gonna mix them all up. Could use a fork. You could also use, what's it called? I just use a spoon. We could also use a fork. You'd also use one of those mixers. What are those things called? Forgot. I assume that anything you have around the house will do to mix it up. You add your 1/4 cup of roasted red peppers. You can say use a mayonnaise jar as well. This is the thing that's going to really add flavor to your cheese sauce you can put on the cheeseburgers. They add a lot of flavor. The roasted part adds a nice touch of barbecue-ishness. The peppers themselves add a little bit of flavor. It's really going to make that cheese have a little extra special flavor. The cayenne pepper adds a little spice. This adds some sweetness and adds some goodness into the cheese. If you have leftover cheese, it works great on hot dogs or even making your own grilled cheese sandwich with the same cheese. It's very useful whenever you're going to melt your cheese. I like to chop my bell peppers really fine. You do not have to chop them so fine, but I like it really fine. I'm going to add those along with the 6 ounces of cheese into the mixing bowl. At this point, it's better to use a spoon. I'm going to add in the roasted bell peppers. Then we're going to stir it all together. There we go. That looks nice and blended. Now we're going to stick it in the refrigerator for 30 minutes to let all the flavors combine together. Make sure to cover the cheese in saran wrap so it doesn't dry out in the refrigerator. Now let's prepare the meat for the barbecue. I put a little oil on my board so that the meat won't stick to the board as much. And it's that light little texture of oil you want on the beef patties. So just spread it out on the board, because we're going to use the board to pound the meat out. Take about half of the meat, and take about half of the half. So we're going to do it in about a quarter of each of the meat. That means each cheeseburger will have about 3/8 of a pound. If I did my math correctly. Take the meat, roll it up in a nice ball, mush it together. I'm going to flatten it out in a little bit. Take the meat, smash it together, roll it into a nice ball. If you feel one of your balls is bigger than the other, then you can add some meat from it to the other one. One thing about ground beef is it tastes better fresh. I bought this ground beef yesterday. The most you want to leave it in your refrigerator is for about 2 days before you use it. Now we're going to make them into patties. Take the round ball, put it right onto the patty. Take the round ball, put it onto your oiled surface, and put a little hole in the middle. Use your thumb to make the middle a little smaller. It's going to puff out when you cook it. Do that for all four of them. Now that you've got all four patties laid out, time to sprinkle a little salt and pepper on it. Flip them over so the other side gets nice and oiled too. And a second sprinkling of salt and pepper. This one has a little bit of cracking. You don't want to see the cracking. That's going to make the burger split when you cook it. So we're going to heat it up a little bit. When we cook them, this side is going to stay up first so that when you flip it, the divot side comes up afterwards, and it's easier to put the cheese inside the divot. Now the burgers are ready to go. Let's get the grill ready. Today I'm going to use my gas grill. First thing to do is take the cover off. I want to keep the grill grates lasting for a long time, so before I even turn it on, first thing I do is add some avocado oil. I use avocado oil because it has the highest flame point of the oils you can find. So when my grill gets up to 500, 600 degrees, the avocado oil will not burn. Once all the racks are oiled up, it's time to turn it on. Close it and let it heat up for about 5 to 10 minutes. While the grill's heating up, it's a good time to get the hamburger buns ready for the broiler. I found if you want to cook them all at once, you could do it on the outside barbecue. You can also do it on the inside broiler. So that you don't disturb cooking everything you're doing on the barbecue with trying to cook hamburger buns. Now they're ready to be put in the broiler. My grill says about 500 degrees, good time to put on the burgers. Make sure you close the lid. You're going to cook it for about 3 to 4 minutes this way. Woo.
My grill's flaming up a bit. Something that I flick, you'll see a nice brown on one side. Not quite there yet. Have it cooking for a little longer. You know, I'm going to check periodically. There's a lot of flame going on because there's lots of oil hitting the coals below. Those coals are just ceramic coals, not the real thing. But it adds a lot of flavor when you got the fire going. Don't worry too much about the flame ups. If you close the lid, it takes care of the too much of the flames. When you close the lid, the flames aren't as bad. Alright, let's see. This one's licked the strength bit, so let's turn it over. Looks like it's probably pretty good. You can see all the flame, you can see how much the burger is shrink up. That's why I flipped a little too early. There's too much flame. Move it away from the flame for a bit. But you can see the nice charring on that burger. That's pretty well done at the right place. That one burger needs a little more charring, so I put it in the back where the flames are. The burgers here are cooking quite quickly, so I'm going to have to add the cheese very soon. Once you flip them over, you're going to put the cheese on the burgers after about a minute or two of cooking. Now they cook for a little bit on the other side, let's add the cheese. I took it away from the flame, so it's not going to be as hot. A heaping spoonful of cheese on each burger. Or two. You want to have a nice thick layer and cover it well. Once you have the cheese on, close the lid back up so they can melt the cheese. If you think the burgers are getting too done, you can put them into a warming area where the cheese continues to melt while the burgers don't cook. So I put the burgers up in a nice little warming area. The cheese will melt and the burgers won't cook anymore because they look pretty well done. Ah, that cheese looks nice and gooey, ready to take off. Nice and gooey, ready to put on the hamburger buns. Once you finish your grill for the day, you want to scrape off the grill with one of these. You can do it while it's still hot. You want to take off any food that got stuck to the grill and then put it back to high. If you put it any lower, put it to high, cook it for 10 minutes and then turn it off. That'll cook off all of the food that was left on the grill. It'll keep your grills lasting longer. I have the oven set to full broil, so it'll toast the tops of the bread nicely. With the oven set to full broil, go ahead and put in your hamburger buns. Make sure Make sure to set a timer so you don't forget. It only takes about a minute to cook them this way. I can see through the grate they're already turning brown. Can't tell you how many times I've burned hamburger buns this way. There you go, nice and toasted. There you have it, nice and toasted hamburger buns. A nicely done cheeseburger ready for the condiments to be added. My son and daughter like different things on it, so I let them decide what to put on. Now it's on to the reaction. Here is a full spread of food I had barbecued today. Grilled peppers. The cheeseburger. We got the avocado and tomato and lettuce for toppings. Cheeseburgers, some bacon cooked by my son, a zucchini, tomato, basil, mozzarella, balsamic vinegar salad, my son's burger, my burger, and all the fixes you might want. My son likes the bacon and the barbecue sauce. Anything else, Teddy?
No.
Anything else?
My doctor is putting on ketchup, lettuce. What else are you putting on, Camellia? Avocado. Mayonnaise. Wow, that's a lot of mayonnaise. You got your barbecue sauce on there now, Teddy?
Yep. The addition of the Bobby Flay cheese makes the bacon barbecue burger taste much better.
Yeah. Now it's Camellia's turn.
Very messy, but now it's perfect.